So one of the great things about having Apple devices, a Mac on your desktop and then an iPhone in your pocket, is that you can do things like figure out directions on your Mac and then send them to your iPhone so you have them as you're actually traveling. So for instance, here I'm in the Maps app on my Mac. I'm using Sierra and I'm going to go to directions and I'm going to find some directions here, and it's going to give me the map here, and I can choose the route I want to take. So it's like choose this route here. And I've got my directions here on the left. I can choose drive, walk, public transit. I'm all ready to go. And I could study these and memorize these and actually go on my trip. Or I can go to file, share, and I can send it to my iPhone. So I'm going to send it to my iPhone 7 Plus right now. And then you can see on my iPhone here, I got a little notification that it was sent to me. Let's tap that notification, and sure enough, there are the directions. And I can hit the go button and we'll start navigating. I can also send other things besides directions. For instance, I can control click here on a map and hit drop pin. And it will drop a pin for a marked location. And I can get info on it and get directions to it. But I could also share that to my iPhone. And you could see here a map's location, and I can hit show and it will show me that location as well. I could add it to favorites there on my iPhone. I could have also added it to favorites here. So let's do that here. Let's hit Pepsi Center here, hit I, and I could see down here at the bottom I could add to favorites. And now in the Maps app here I could actually go and search for places, but I could look at this list of favorites here and I should see the Pepsi Center appear. There it goes. It just took a second there, but you saw it appeared and I can get to it. So it's easy to add favorites that way and just have iCloud sync them rather than sharing directly using the share function.